We're here today at Great Futures in Riyadh, and I'm going to be interviewing leaders from across the arts, music, fashion, sport, finance and more to talk transformation. Thank you so much today for joining me to talk transformation. If you wouldn't mind just by starting, introduce yourself, a little bit of background about yourself.
So I'm Will, the CEO of Brompton, this little bicycle here. And I have been working at Brompton for 22 years. I started there because I met a guy randomly on a bus. A business is like a sort of an insect on acid. It's permanently having to shed its shell and do a new one and grow, and then shed its shell and do a new one and grow. And occasionally it sheds its shell and it completely transforms from a, you know, a caterpillar into a butterfly, which no one was expecting. And all this weird stuff keeps going on. You need to get away from looking at the top line, beautiful stuff, and just keep looking under the glacier at the hardcore, difficult infrastructure stuff. So for us, data. Understanding data. We're building a data analytics team. I didn't know what a data brick was like 18 months ago, and now it's a really important part of our business. And then also customer journey from an e-com perspective, and we're in 46 countries, but one of those is China. China is a completely different world to the rest of the world, and you need to invest in technology, but that's quite expensive, and do you really need to invest in it? And then, you know, in China, do you want to be on Little Red Book? Do you want to be on Tmall? Do you want to be on WhatsApp mini app? And like, whoa, where do you stop? So getting the sort of holding your nerve and standing back and not getting involved in this stuff and going, really, really? Okay, let's do that and do it well. Do that and do it well. Do that and do it well. And even if top line goes funny, that might be because, you know, the market's shifting like sands in the desert. But if you get the fundamentals right, and then you do next year, you get some other fundamentals right, over 3 or 4 years, you will grow. You will get better. And it will just happen because you've done the proper stuff rather than farting around and getting all excited about the trendy, sexy stuff at the top. So I'm permanently down here worrying about fundamentals.
Super interesting. What about your industry as a whole? You've obviously been very disruptive in the space. What do you see as the opportunities going forward in, you know, the next few years for the industry?
If you stand right back and look at the world, the little planet Earth that we're living on, most of us now live in cities. And we have a global warming crisis, but no one seems to be taking it seriously enough, sadly. It's coming a bit slow, but it is coming. But the one that governments are really beginning to think about is health. And we have some major health problems coming down the track. Diabetes, mental health, heart disease. And that's because we are not doing enough activity. And it's no good, you know, going to a gym and, you know, getting on a bike and pedaling and going nowhere. You need to build an active lifestyle. So we need to design our cities, not around the car, but around the human being. And it will happen because governments can't afford to continue the way they're going.
So interesting. Much more than a product, more a lifestyle shift for people. You've already shared some much wisdom with me, but any other words of wisdom or advice maybe you wish you'd had as you were starting out on this journey that you would offer to other leaders who are thinking about change and transformation in their own space?
My advice, forget leaders, to anyone. We are pretty irrelevant as people. We're going to be dead in a minute. We'll come and go like days of the week. So get on with it. Get on with your life. Don't dilly-dally. Really pile in there, because just doing nothing is just so boring. Take risks. Get stuck in. No one, when they're on death's door, goes, oh, I wish I hadn't done that stuff. They always regret not doing more. So do more. Get out of bed. Kick some ass. Take some risk. Make yourself feel a bit scared. Because we need to, because we've got to make the world better. And it won't happen by just dawdling around and hoping someone else will do it.
Well, Nick, thank you for your inspirational product, for your inspirational words. And it's been a pleasure talking to you.